everybody. So, sooner or later, all balloon twisters may find themselves in situations where we have to work much faster than usually, situations where we have to make a lot of balloons and we have very limited time. Usually, these situations go hand in hand with a crowd of people seeking entertainment, in our case, balloons. Whether you volunteering or working for profit, it does not matter, it is your chance to be the star. And there are different ways to achieve success in such situations. Generally speaking, we can underline some ways. For example, we can avoid situations where we have to make more balloons sculptures than we're actually capable of. We can get assistance, crowd control, we can use special equipment, and of course we can use fast balloon twisting technique. Now let's get into details. Avoid situations where you have to work more than you can. Avoiding situations does not mean canceling the job. It is the last thing you want to do. But you have to be honest to yourself and to your customers. It helps most often. Accept only job offers that you can actually fulfill based on your abilities. You know how many balloons you may inflate in 1 hour time or in 10 minutes, for instance. It gives you an approximate estimation of how many relatively simple balloon sculptures you can make in any given period of time. Let's assume that I can serve about 20 children in 1 hour period. If my client invited 4-5 dozen of kids on his birthday party, then I would not be able to serve balloon sculptures to all of his guests, if only I have 1 hour to work with them. Instead of accepting this job on such terms, I would rather make him alternative proposal of what I realistically can do to serve him and his guests. For example, he can increase my working hours, make it 2-3 hours, or he should include payment for my helper assistant. Or instead of making balloon sculptures for each kid on the party, I would make one large balloon decoration for everyone. Or I can just entertain kids for 1 hour using balloons as props for games and such thing. Get assistance. You can come across different kind of jobs. Often it is impossible to do all the work related to one particular job by yourself. You need an assistance for such occasions. Best of all is to get in touch in advance with professional balloon twisters who know the job. Then you know who to call to get the help with your job. However, any helper, even non-professional, could be your lifesaver in any big job. For example, most people can inflate and tie off balloons. This work doesn't require any special skills. And then it takes very little time to teach any person to make basic balloon sculptures. You may find a helper among your family members, friends, people you know or probably never met before. Any volunteer willing to help you and learn balloon twisting at the same time will do. And in any long waiting line, you may find someone who would rather learn balloon twisting than just wait in a line. You just have to ask. Making balloon animals is much more interesting than waiting in a line. Giving people such an opportunity, you can serve many more clients. At the same time, you will provide entertainment to those waiting in a line, and you will take the situation under your control. Crowd control. Serving many people at any big event requires special handling. Best of all, to organize people in a waiting line. You have to secure enough room for you to work with balloons. Well-organized working space will allow you to focus on making balloon sculptures. It makes sense to sort balloons in advance by size, by color, by shapes. An apron with pockets is indispensable for this purpose. Often it is hard to figure out what balloon sculptures a child is asking you to make. You can save time by asking the following customer all related questions while you are making sculpture for the current client. People tend to make choices from what they see or out of what you offer to them. This is main reason for you to refrain from making any time-consuming balloon sculptures. Use one, two, maybe three balloons per one sculpture. Also, instead of asking questions about what balloon sculpture people want, you may give them ready to use answers. The answers could be in the form of questions. For example, you may ask a child, would you like to have a green dog on a leash? You have never seen a green dog? Well, watch me make it. And I will make this dog with a big eyes. Do you think the green dog will look good with a yellow leash? What would you say now? Do you like this dog or should I give it to someone else? Majority of people, and especially children, prefer to keep the toy made with their help. Games are probably one of the most effective and unobstructive ways to control children. Various games can be used in different circumstances. Below you will find links to descriptions of different games with balloons. Important to remember, we make balloon animals for entertaining. Games are pure form of entertaining. Balloons are just props for the games. Inviting people to play games with balloons, you are entertaining them, and at the same time, you are gaining time to make balloon sculptures using special equipment. You can find all kinds of equipment at your local specialty stores caring for balloon twisters. Most certainly, a portable electrical air pump is one of the must-have tools for such occasions. Also, a dual-action hand air pump is an indispensable tool for any work with balloons. And of course, large-size floor-standing air pump looks very attractive, and it can inflate 1 to 60 balloon in one move. You may ask balloon twisters, professionals, or people who work at the specialty stores, maybe they will give you some more suggestions about special equipment. And of course, fast balloon twisting technique. Skills comes with experience. Most balloon sculptures can be made using different technique. The best and the fastest way to make the same sculpture is the one you're using now. Any other fast way to make the same sculpture, it would take time to learn and to make it perfect. You can and should learn to use it in your spare time. But basically we can say that fast balloon twisting technique come to making in one move a number of bubbles and locking them in one lock twist. I'm gonna give you some examples of fast balloon twisting technique.
Fully inflate any color balloon, leaving no flat tail. Fold the balloon about 7, maybe 8 inches away from the nozzle. Hold the balloon about 2 inches away from the nozzle in one hand. At this spot you twist 3 bubbles in one move. At the same time you lock both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. Then you have to force the base of the third, the long bubble, through the loop of the second bubble. You have made one balloon sort. In the following example, we're going to make a stem with 2 leaves. Inflate green balloon, leaving 1, 2, maybe 3 inch flat tail. Fold the balloon 3 times. We can adjust the size of the stem or size of the leaves, make it smaller, larger, it's up to you. Hold the balloon at the middle in one hand. At this point, we twist in one move 4 bubbles. At the same time, we lock both ends of the second and the third bubble in one lock twist. We have made the stem with leaves. In this example, I'm going to use 3-fold head to make a basic flower. We have to lock all ends of all 3 bubbles of the head in one lock twist. We have made the flower. Now we have to attach either side of the stem between bubbles of the flower. Hold the stem about 2 inches away from the round end of the balloon and force it between petals of the flower. We have made the flower using fast twisting technique. Have fun and happy twisting!